Welcome to Survival Gear List video series.
Today I'm going to take you through a new app from the American Red Cross that has some pretty neat features. And as you can see on the screen, I have several American Red Cross apps. Those are all the ones in red and white. And the new one is called Emergency. So it has some pretty neat features that you can monitor locations for different weather-related emergencies. And you can start adding people like your grandparents and your parents and brothers and sisters. So that way, if there is, let's say, a tornado warning in that town, you can get a hold of them. And you could actually tell them to take shelter if they don't know that a tornado has touched the ground. So let's go in and add a location. You can also track your current location. So I'm going to add in New York. All right, there's New York. And it drops in a pin on the island of New York. We'll go next. Do you know anyone that lives in New York? Thankfully, no. So we'll move on. So I've added New York. And now we can either add more locations. So let's say you have grandparents in Florida, because that's where they all live. Or you could do somebody out on the West Coast or anywhere else in the United States that you can you have relatives. So let's go in and start working on the New York radius. So you can make it really local to just 1 mile from, let's say, your house. Or you can zoom all the way out to a 50-mile radius. So that's going to cover, parts of New Jersey and other parts of Manhattan Island. Let's say we want to just decrease it right around there. So that's a 33-mile radius. Okay, so you can set that to whatever you want. Then you can also go in and set your different notification warning. So you can do hurricanes, which we know every once in a while a hurricane does go up there. You can do warnings and watches, tropical storms, high wind warnings. You can go in. All right, let's maybe do a high wind warning in case trees are going to come down. Earthquake warnings. I don't think that's such a big one for New York, so I'm going to turn that one off. Flash floods. We saw in the movie The Day After, New York flooded, so we'll leave that one on. So you can just go through all of these and find different ones that you want to set alerts for. That was coastal flooding. Tornado warnings is turned on. Tornado watch, okay, that's turned on. Blizzards, we know that they have blizzards there, so that's good. Tsunami warnings, all right. That's all covered up. Fire watch, all right. Red flag fire warnings, I don't know if New York is too worried about that one, so we'll turn that one off. Severe thunderstorms, great. Excessive heat, that one's turned on, okay, good. Ash warning, got to be careful when you say that one. The volcano warning, I don't think New York has too much to worry about volcanoes. Maybe if it's in Iceland, so we'll turn all those off. Hazardous materials, New York has had its own problems with that. Evacuation, that's a good one. Wind advisory, we can turn that one on. You never know. The wind advisory, so that's all turned on. So then we'll keep going. General notifications. So I think we got all the notifications for New York. Now you can set your own. Again, if you have relatives that are living in Florida, our tropical storm and hurricane warnings are good. Or if you have ones living in Oklahoma City, you probably would turn off the hurricane version, but definitely tornadoes is important. So you can go along and add people that live here as well, or you can delete locations. So you can start setting up more and more locations. This app also has information on how to become prepared for a flood, so right before, during, or after, planning ahead for a flood. So it had just basic tips that you can go through and what you should get as part of your package, your preparedness essentials for a flood or a home fire. Hurricane, what to do during a hurricane. So it has a lot of great little features in it. You can take quizzes on different things about a drought. Or you can also map. This is another neat feature it has, is you can map where there are Red Cross evacuation centers. So it looks like there's a bunch going on. I think it's because of all the rain that they're having in Texas and Oklahoma and tornadoes. But you can, if you have Wi-Fi, you can actually get on the network and find out where the locations are for places to evacuate and Red Cross centers. So they basically have them all for the entire country. So you can see the location, see the address, get directions for these evacuation centers. So it's pretty neat. Then they have, you can get their other apps. As you can see, they have quite a bit. You can donate money to them right away. There's another part of their app that I have found, and I haven't found it on this one yet. We'll go out to one of their other apps. So under Earthquake, you can go in and set up a pretty neat thing. You can edit your message. So let's say you have a tornado or an earthquake and the phone lines are busy, but you can still get Wi-Fi. You can set up different recipients to receive an email. You can type your message like, "We just had a giant earthquake, but I'm okay." And then you can send that via Twitter and Facebook, via text message or email out to your contact list and let everyone know that they're okay. So it's a that's a great feature that you can hit real fast. So if there is something that just hit you right away, especially like an earthquake or a tornado, you could broadcast your message just saying, "Hey, we just had a tornado. Family's fine. We'll get in touch with you later." So some of these, the different parts of the Red Cross apps are really great, and they're all free. So that's a great thing to add to your phone as far as your preparedness features. So I definitely think you should put those on your phone, and hope that's been helpful.